Dirt was flying at sites across Prince George's County recently as a host of county officials broke ground for 6 brand new schools. Thanks to an historic P3 public-private partnership dubbed Blueprint Schools, a group of companies will plan, finance, and fast-track the new school construction in a county where more than half the 208 schools are over 50 years old. Listening to speakers like Elsie Jacobs lament aged buildings like Drew Freeman Middle School, and then seeing everyone's joy as the good earth was moved, it was abundantly clear that the newfound urgency to build new was long overdue.
And I was so concerned since I've been out there 20 years ago, just think of what all these children and the staff had to go through.
This building was constructed in 1960. And if you look at the building behind me, you can tell that not much has changed since it was constructed. But in public education, 1960 feels like a lifetime ago. The way we teach and the way our students learn has dramatically changed. We need environments that support the way that we teach and learn today.
We are here to deliver on a promise. We are so serious about the promise that we're delivering on, and that promise is to the children of Prince George's County, to those who educate them, to their families, saying to them that we believe that their education, we understand that in America, education is the great equalizer, and saying to our children that we believe that they are valuable, we believe in their dignity, and we believe that they deserve to have facilities that are befitting of their dignity. And so today is delivering on a promise that says a 60-year-old school should come down and we should build a new one, and we should build one that is ready for the 21st century.
Destined to save the school district $174 million in design, construction, and maintenance costs over the next 30 years, the 6 new schools, 5 middle schools, and 1 academy, to be completed in just 2 years instead of the typical 7, they will provide 8,000 students with dazzling new ecologically friendly buildings that are bathed in natural light, offer abundant open spaces, and have a signature staircase as a gathering spot for children. But as much as the new schools at Adelphi, Kenmore, Walker Mill, Drew Freeman, Hyattsville, and the new South County Academy will delight the eye, it is also the academic rigor they'll offer that is already entrancing students, even those who won't directly benefit.
I'm really excited about the new Kenmore Middle School building, and I think the school will serve many generations to come. As a current student, I am happy to know that our input was used to help create some of the plans for the construction of the new school building. That garden is going to be amazing. Okay. While I will no longer be in Kenmore Middle School when the new school opens, I'm happy to know so many younger students in my community will be able to benefit from the new building.
As one of the first U.S. school systems to use alternative financing to build schools, Prince George's County is being recognized for being in the vanguard. But the foresight and boldness don't end with these 6 new schools. They are just the beginning of a plan to modernize a county determined to show its pride in its structures and its children.
I have no doubt that other school systems in the state of Maryland and beyond will look at Prince George's with admiration and inspiration for moving one step closer to ensuring that every child achieves their highest potential in their modern school buildings.
I started my first week on the job and had to close the school and move students a week before school began, and people recall. I never want to put any other person in that situation, let alone our students, our families, and our teachers. This is a historic event for us. We've never been able to build 6 schools in 2 years. And the truth is that it's not just these 6. We have 4 more that we followed a traditional route. They'll be delivered 2 years after that. So 10 schools being built in 4 years has never been done before, but it's the time.
You can follow the new Blueprint School's progress at www.pgcpsblueprintschools.com. This is Dave Zirin reporting.